What's going on, my fellow residents? What's going on, my fellow residents? It's me, TheFrozenCavern, and today we're going to finish our journey through Kingdom Hearts 2 Final Mix. In the last episode, we first went up against Xemnas for the first time ever. And in this episode, we're going to end our Kingdom Hearts 2 journey. It has been a long journey. It has been months. It's been good long months. When did I start this? It was like in July, I think. That's actually kind of crazy. Because only October in this game's getting beaten. So July, it might have been before that actually. July, August, September, and then October. So at least 4 months. That's ready, that's crazy. But indeed, it all ends here.
So, it seems your hearts have led you to obliteration. Perhaps it doesn't pay to be too loyal to one's heart. I will have to be sure and remember that.
No! We can take him on our own.
And this essentially means you do not have Mickey for the remainder of this game. By the way, there is no one who hates this scene. If you find anyone who hates this scene, unfriend them immediately. But let's get going. We have quite a long while because remember with Kingdom Hearts 1 and all of its multiple phases? This is no different. It has a bunch of phases to it. And also, there is a way to kind of go past everything, but it's... ow. Why didn't the reaction command show up there? Okay, that's weird. There we go. For some reason it didn't, but when you have certain abilities, you can actually get past all these, like, faster, and you only have to do this once, so... Realistically, you're supposed to do this, like, 4 times, but I accidentally got hit by one of the buildings, and, like, most of the other ones were... you know, I just sliced through them. Alright, Magnet also helps this go by way faster because these things only need to get hit once, so as soon as they spawn, they just instantly go back there. So it ends up making this go by way faster than it need be, which does end up helping us out. And we don't have to worry too much about the whole charge thing. Also, physics. I mean, with a game like Kingdom Hearts, physics shouldn't be like... too high of a priority, but still, physics, it's still there. Okay, we're not gonna be able to get all of it? No, we're not. We still need one more, which is pretty much what the other one did. Alright, just a little bit more experience. Let's go. Alright. Now we have to destroy this energy core, which isn't exactly the hardest thing in the world since it's kind of just pure. But there are, like, certain phases where you stop and have to defeat these other nobodies because, for whatever reason, the giant shield is just there. So you can't, fight against the core anymore, like, besides that. But once we take out all these nobodies, we'll be able to do that. And we have to do that a good number of times, I think. Nah, not 4, maybe 3. Actually, I don't really know, but let's attack the core again. So this is the second time. And we're gonna have Riku doing a little bit of extra damage with the Dark Aura thing that I mentioned last episode. Alright, time for more nobodies and berserkers, yay. Those are fun to fight, especially in this relatively small area. And also, Xemnas will sometimes, like, just attack with part of the structure. I mean, there are times where it'll just completely miss, but it'll come up out of nowhere and you won't be able to react too much in time. There might be a sound cue, but I have no idea what it is, if that's the case. Oh, I guess the information bar... okay, ow. The information bar above says so. Stop it. Stop hitting me. Please. Stop. Actually, stop. Alright, take care of you now. Please. There we go. Alright, so now we have these two to take care of, and it should be relatively over for this little segment. Please. Okay. You didn't go back into the ground, because that would have taken forever. My goodness, die already. There we go. Back to the barrier, if this thing was not in the way. But I think we can end up defeating this with just this. There might be one more segment. I'm not entirely sure on that. All I know is that it's not time-based, or at least I don't believe it's time-based. There we go. Let me heal up, just to be safe. Oh, wait, proceed. I forgot you actually have to proceed, onward. Alright, and now we have this armor thing here. And it'll just sit there, kind of like how the core did, but now we have to fight off against all these weapons that the organization members have used before, and some of their attacks are pretty similar. I mean, the only ones that are noticeable are, Zaldan's, which I think it's using again, maybe? Yeah, it's using it again. There's Zimnus's barrier there that he just used. Luxor's cards. I do see Zigbar's guns, but I don't see too much of an effect from it. And then Sykes' Claymore is on the side. Axel's Chakrams. Is there anything else? Don't think there is, but this little segment is relatively easy. And also that scream is very painful. I wonder who did the voice for that scream. I don't really know.
Zemnas, there's more to a heart than just anger or hate. It's full of all kinds of feelings. Don't you remember?
Unfortunately, I don't.
Gosh! You all did great.
You're coming back with us, right?
I had given in to the darkness.
Riku!
How am I gonna face everyone?
Like this?
I'll open a path.
Huh? Oh. You don't belong in the Dark Realm anymore, Riku.
How do we get out of here, Your Majesty?
Well, I'm not sure. But we better hurry and get through.
And yeah, Pluto kind of just appeared out of nowhere.
Thank you, Naminé.
Sure.
See? We meet again, like we promised.
Huh? You said we'd meet again. But when we did, we might not recognize each other.
I did, didn't I?
But I knew you.
It's strange.
I think I understand. I see myself the way you remember me. And you see yourself the way I remember you.
I always thought nobodies were doomed to fade back into darkness.
Yeah. But you and I didn't. We got to meet our original selves.
So, we can be together again.
Right. Anytime Sora and Kairi are together.
We'll be together every day. Right, Sora?
Yeah.
Other games say otherwise.
sharp.
Huh?
Don't worry. You're all still you.
Hey, let's go home.
Riku, come on.
Yeah.
Sora! Riku!
What?
Yeah, things aren't over yet. It is very convenient that this glider is here that is never mentioned throughout any of the the rest of the series, ever. Alright, now in terms of songs, this is one of my favorite songs in the game, Darkness of the Unknown, which is kind of vague considering how many different versions of Darkness of the Unknown actually exist, but like this is one of my favorite versions. It's so good, and it also like drastically builds up. Well, kind of. I guess it's more like through particular segments it builds up. But there is one thing that's kind of bad about this is that we can't heal throughout all of this. So yeah, health is kind of it's kind of scarce, and unfortunately there are some attacks where it's going to be pretty difficult to actually dodge them, so yeah, we're gonna have to take some mandatory health, unfortunately, but we'll do our best to work around it. I need to make sure I take as little damage as possible, I say, as I'm getting hit. That's very nice. I kind of don't want to do the thing. There we go. Alright, I want to save this Mega Laser for like the next segment, which I'm pretty sure is on the left side here. But this whole Darkness of the Unknown thing, it will build up as like separate, well, not really phases, because there are more fights after this, so that's what I mean by it kind of builds up. Okay, Mega Laser now. This thing does a lot of damage, so if you can get it on like a new part, make sure you can, because it is very, very worth it. We unfortunately are like half our health, and we do still have like two more things to destroy. Hopefully we will last. But I think this attack, which is about to come up, this is the one where we... Well, no, not this. It's the attack after this. Or at least I'm pretty sure it is. Yep, it is. This is the attack that's really difficult to actually dodge. I say as I don't get hit. Okay, I usually get hit by that move, but you know, whatever. And also, this fight can be... it can be slow. If it's not your first time playing the game, it's slow, unfortunately. But if it isn't, then... well, if it is your first time playing the game, then it's really good. Because it's just a giant air battle in the sky, and you're basically still fighting for all the worlds, basically the universe. Come on. Can I get this thing? There we go. I'm gonna save the Mega Laser for the last wing. Hopefully we live to see said last wing get destroyed. But there's not too much left. He does this one attack again, and I somehow manage to dodge it again. Alright, come on, get us over there. And we attack now. And thankfully we also have invincibility while we're doing the Mega Laser, so we don't get extremely punished whenever we're doing it. And we have to wait for the actual thing to close out. There we go. By the way, something I could have mentioned is that there was a alternate version of this. I guess a concept art, that's what it's more called. But a concept art of something like this happening, but it was basically like a giant titan human thing with a crown, and the whole thing was basically made of the city, kind of like how this ship thing was.
To say it, not until everything was back to the way it was before.
Don't worry, we'll make that happen. Once this is over, you can thank her all you want.
Yeah.
All right, time to face the armor one last time. And also, this is my favorite version of this actual Darkness of the Unknown theme. This is what I meant when I said that the song builds up throughout the fight. But as you can tell, it's basically kind of the same fight at first with Jessora and Riku this time, but you'll see in a second just why it's not the same thing. Let me heal so I don't end up dying, because I do not want to die on this boss. By the way, we're kind of shifting a bit, and now you notice that he's not taking any more damage, so you have to get hit. And now for this little segment only, we actually have this glide move. So, I was about to get hit there. But what you have to do is fly over to one of these standing still buildings and just reaction command. That way you can break the shield and actually go back onto the area where you were fighting. And that's implying I don't get hit. I can die this way. Stop it. Stop. Okay. Let's get down there and actually fight. Alright, get over here, you. Oh my goodness. Yeah, that... Oh, right, I also forgot. The ship sways a little bit, so any aerial movement, and sometimes ground movement, that actually affects you a lot. And Riku, can you not just run into... Riku, please. Oh, he's gonna smack us away again. Just go ahead and do it. And unfortunately, there's not really anything you can do about the whole him smacking you away so that you have to redo this. Granted, it's still cool, but let's get over to here. Come on. There we go. By the way, how we have the power to just smack buildings into shields that cause explosions like this, I will never know, but whatever. It's Kingdom Hearts physics, everyone. Video game physics in general. There we go. Okay, that did a lot of damage. Let's heal off of that. Come on. Oh my goodness. I could die here. I can't drive. Okay, thank you, Riku. Oh my goodness. Okay, this last little segment is being a little annoying. Please stop. And also, we have double jump, and it is super magnified, so that you'll just go soaring into the air whenever you do a double jump. Okay, you're almost dead. I'm actually almost dead as well. Okay. Thank you, Riku. I didn't mean to waste a potion there, but kind of healed me a little late there. Oh my goodness, please. Also, Riku has a very hard time dying. And as I say that, he just dies. But I would love to get over it and kill you right now. This is like the longest it's actually taken for me to kill him. Come on. There we go. Oh my goodness, please. Get over... What did I get hit? Okay. Oh my goodness. I'm not this bad at this boss. Let's just reflect. There. Goodness, that took 5 years to do. I don't know why... That was the worst I've actually done that segment. And I usually don't do that all that bad. But now I kind of have little items to actually use in this fight. Unless they refresh. I'm pretty sure they do. Aside from my ether, because I'm pretty sure I have no more.
I will not allow it to end this way. Not yet. If light and darkness are eternal, Then surely we nothings must be the same. Eternal.
You're right. Light and darkness are eternal. Nothing probably goes on forever, too. But guess what, Xemnas?
That doesn't mean you're eternal.
No more eternal than that radiance of yours.
And now, the final phase of the final boss of the game. Let's go! And by the way, he's gonna start off with this. Oh, I have no health. But, thankfully... Okay, I didn't expect that to happen. I was trying to mash the triangle button there. Let's ignore that happened. I had no health. That was not my fault. Okay, actually worked this time, reaction command. Reaction command, why do I get hit first? That's unfair. But this is another example of why it's good that my Kingdom Hearts 2 Let's Play, it wasn't really delayed, but I just got lucky in terms of timing because that segment was completely broken when 1.5 first came, well, 1.5 plus 2.5 came out. It was so bad. Like, half the time the actual reaction command would not show up, and I'm doing really badly here. Let me heal, okay. Alright, punish now. Okay, he's not... I have to play this really defensively, which I'm not really all that used to. Yeah, like, he won't take too much stun from my attack, so I have to be really careful about things. Get over here, you. That's fun. Okay. Oh, I just realized I gotta be really careful about whenever I'm low on health, because if I'm too low, he can just do a move that will pretty much instantly kill me. Okay, heal now. There we go. I have to heal just in case. Riku unfortunately healed me at the same time, so he has nothing for himself, but... yeah, I have no ethers, that's bad. Right. That's annoying. Every time I think I have a chance to actually punish him, I can't. Because he'll immediately, or just teleport away, whenever I do think I have a chance. Yeah, like he'll do that, vine move thing. Thank you. Riku gets his healing thing back very quickly. So it's not exactly easy to die in this fight, but it's not hard either. Oh my goodness. I have to pick and choose my fights very, very precisely. Otherwise, this is going to go very badly. I have, like, very little health right now. Ah, that was bad. I meant to block. But you can just block these lasers. If you need to, make sure you turn in the direction. Okay. I was about to say that I have, like, the... timing memorized for these, but yeah, that just clearly proved that I didn't. Alright. Come on. Okay, yeah, I'm really bad for those because I think those are supposed to actually have audio cues, but they kind of don't, so... running around doesn't really help out much for that. You have to block those. So, I actually might need to be quiet. There we go. They didn't have an audio cue there, but I just guessed the timing. Oh, come on! Oh, no. Okay, this is a little bad. I might live through this, depending on how much of health is drained at a time for Sora. It shouldn't be that much, but let's hope. Okay, so what I do for this is that I just use Dark Aura to keep this clone or duplicate of Xemnas away as I'm running up to save Sora, because if his HP gets too low, well, no, if his HP reaches zero, Sora will die. And if Riku dies, then the fight's over. So, yeah, just have to be extremely careful whenever you're going through that. Alright, get over here, and now we punish him. And also, one thing that... okay, didn't expect that to happen. Okay, that first attack does not work. Well, first reversal does not work, but whatever. One thing that is kind of bad about this fight is that you can accidentally knock him out of, like, the battle zone. So he'll be able to go outside of it, but you can't. Oh, come on, that was not fair. Where are you? There you go. And now we punish. Capitalize on everything. Oh no. Yeah, I was gonna get hit by that. There's something I could do. Just gonna heal. Get over here. Oh my goodness, stop. Oh, wait, can I not block that? No. Okay. That was very, very close. I had to be very, very careful about that because there's... Oh, my goodness. This is an example of what I mean, but... Like, why have this? Why have that a thing? But, one thing that can happen in the game, and I don't think I've ever actually mentioned it, is that, like, if one particular stun move happens for Sora, then you will, like, just... Oh, Riku has no health here. This is bad. Okay, let's focus on this first, which, by the way, is one of the longest reaction command segments in the entire game, and I have to mash the X and triangle buttons at the same time. I'm holding my controller in a very weird position right now, but it's to help make sure that I don't end up dying. You guys probably hear me mashing the buttons, and I'm talking a lot, and that's kind of making me lose focus. Okay. Okay, thankfully none of those shots were towards Riku because he probably would have died. I did get hit a Sora twice, I think. It might have been three times. I know it was at least twice. Oh goodness, that was close. There are many times where you can die in this fight, so it's a decent challenge, but it can be done. By the way, unfortunately, that's not actually the last hit. So, how about we make this something to remember? Infinity, let's go. Oh, and I leveled up from it. Nice. That also helps out. Really helpful since this is the end of the game, but whatever. And that's the end of Kingdom Hearts 2. Everything else is just cutscenes from here on out. So I can actually put my controller down.
We did it! I wouldn't be too sure of that. Sora. I can't. Don't say another word. It's not over. It's just not. How can you say that? Even if we could go on. Look where we are.
Aw, come on, Riku. You've been hanging out in darkness too long. You gotta try and think positive.
Sora?
Hmm?
You lead.
Got it.
You know, I always figured I was better at stuff than you.
Really? Hmm.
Are you mad?
No. I kinda always thought you were better at everything, too. Riku, look. What's that light?
End of the road.
Yep.
Put me down. I can walk.
You know, maybe the darkness has gotten to me too. Riku!
This world is perfect for me. If this is what the world really is, just this, then maybe I should fade back into darkness.
Riku!
If the world is made of light and darkness, we'll be the darkness.
Yeah. The other side. The Realm of Light is safe now. Kairi, the King, and the others are there.
That's what I mean. Hey, Sora. Could you help me? I want to get down to the water. At least the waves sound the same. What I said back there, about thinking I was better at stuff than you? To tell you the truth, Sora, I was jealous of you.
What for?
I wished I could live life the way you do. Just following my heart.
Yeah, well, I've got my share of problems too.
Like what?
Like wanting to be like you.
Well, there is one advantage to being me. Something you can never imitate.
Really? What's that?
Having you for a friend.
Then I guess I'm okay the way I am. I've got something you could never imitate, too.
Yeah, remember that bottle at, like, the beginning of the game? If you somehow remember that.
Sora?
Mm-hmm.
I think it's for you.
Thinking of you wherever you are. We pray for our sorrows to end. And hope that our hearts will blend.
Now I will step forward to realize this wish. And who knows? Starting a new journey may not be so hard. Or maybe it's already begun. There are many worlds. But they share the same sky. One sky. One destiny.
Light.
The door to light.
We'll go together.
Yeah.
always good whenever it comes to Game Mario series. Every single game has amazing soundtrack. Oh, but goodness, we still have a lot more because the credits aren't over. So, you know, that's fun. But, is there anything else that I forgot to mention? Don't really think there is. Okay, I guess I'll try and talk about what's my favorite world or whatever, because I really am never able to, like, decide on these kind of things. So, in terms of favorite world, Like I said, it's going to take me a good while to actually come up with this, because I don't really think about this, like, all that often, unfortunately. I can think of, like, worse or, like, bad, like, bosses or whatever like that, but I can't, like, put them into, like, a top five or whatever. I can't make a countdown about that. I would just have to have a video just titled, like, some bad bosses or worlds or whatever. But, were there any really, like, bad bosses? There weren't really any bad bosses. If you want some bad bosses, go to Days. That is chock-filled with bad bosses. Actually, it's, like, the worst collection of bosses in the entire series, but... Like, when it comes to bosses in Kingdom Hearts 2, all of them are really all-around pretty good. I mean, there are a few exceptions where they're kind of just, like, meh, they could have been better. And, the Grim Reaper from Port Royal is definitely one of those. But, I mean, I like the boss. I like it, but not a lot of other people do. There's also one boss from the Tron world in the first visit. That one was pretty okay as well. But just keep in mind, there aren't... Well, for me, there aren't that many, like, meh bosses in this game. Now, in terms of my least favorite world... It's a tie between Atlantica and Pride Lands. Pride Lands mainly being because of how limiting it can be. And then a good majority, or I guess half of the area, is kind of just bland and just so singular color. But then again, the Land of Dragons also is kind of like that in a way. But, I mean, at least the Land of Dragons doesn't limit your abilities. The Pride Lands does. So, yeah, it has that over that. And then Atlantica, it degraded itself from being a full world filled with all the Heartless and junk like that, and it just turned into a musical. So yeah, a lot of people aren't exactly all that happy about that. But, I mean, Atlantica does give you some decently useful items that you couldn't get anywhere else in the game, but so does other areas in the game. I mean, it's a mixed bag. If you're enjoying it for the memes, then you're probably going to enjoy it decently well, but if you're not, then you're going to have a bad time. Now, in terms of my favorite world, favorite Disney world, let's say that, because I think my favorite world would probably be, I want to say the world that never was, but that probably isn't true. Like I said, I don't really take the time to, like, sit down and think about these things. I just enjoy everything in a general view, or I don't like things in a general view. I don't really have a, like, top whatever. I think that's really it. Everything else here is just basically after the facts for all the Disney worlds and, well, all the worlds, technically, except the world ends with you, because that world's kind of gone at this point. There's not really any major point for it to exist anymore, since it was the Organization 13 stronghold, and, you know, it kind of doesn't exist anymore. I think that was actually everything to talk about, but trust me, go out and play the Kingdom Hearts series yourself if you haven't already, and if you're actually this far into the series of just watching me play the games, because trust me, it will be an experience that you'll more than likely enjoy. I would highly recommend the series to anyone who wants to try something new, and it is on PS4. It's unfortunately not on Xbox One for any of you who are Xbox fans, Although if you are, you probably aren't watching this. I don't really know that though, because there might be people who are fans of the Kingdom Hearts series but only play on Xbox One or stuff like that, because Kingdom Hearts 3 is coming out on the Xbox One, so it's expanding the fan base a little bit. So for all we know, it could easily happen, but just if you have a PS4 or you're wanting to get a PS4 at some point, just try and get 1.5 plus 2.5, because it is, at this point in time, a definitely good buy. For a lot of people, if you were to buy 1.5 plus 2.5, like, at launch, because of all the glitches, well, not really glitches, all the crashes and junk that could happen, a lot of people were debating on whether it would actually be a good thing to buy this, but now that most of the problems have been ironed out, it is definitely worth getting this. And I'm pretty sure that's like a Final Fantasy reference, but I have no idea about that. So yeah, don't kill me about that. I'm not exactly the biggest Final Fantasy fan. To be honest, I probably should get more into the Final Fantasy games, but it's like, I was about to say that, oh, it takes up a lot of time, but this took months to get through. I have Final Fantasy 15, but I got bored of that game, like, at the very beginning. I just got really bored of that. The only Final Fantasy games I've actually beaten are 13, 2, and Crisis Core, which is Final Fantasy 7, but yeah, for some reason, the only games I've beaten are, like, side games to a particular series. I've never actually beaten the main game of, like, the series or whatever it is. And now Sora sees the drawing that Kairi made. Or little addition that Kairi made of her returning the Paopu fruit. Oh, I thought the credits was gonna end. Come on. I would like the credits to end at some point. I think they are now. Oh goodness, this is actually 50 minutes. Oh goodness, okay. Well, I mean, it is a finale, and there's not really much I can do about it, so I kinda have to let it happen. But yeah, like I said, Kingdom Hearts 2, and for some reason, Final Mix isn't up there. And now we have the secret ending, which can be easily unlocked through critical mode. Through standard mode, you have to do a bunch more stuff. Problem mode, you have to do a little bit less, and then you can't unlock it in beginner mode.
Nothing's changed, huh? Nope. Nothing will. What a small world. But part of one that's much bigger. Yeah. Hey, Riku, what do you think it was? The door to the light. This. This? Yeah. It's always closer than you think.
Sora! Riku!
Hey, what's up?
Look.
From the king?
But guess what? You're gonna have to wait until the next game in order to find out. Well, next game, chronologically wise, to find out what's on that letter. But in actual release, like, this game released at first in 2005 in Japan, and then 2006 in everywhere else, and then when was the next game? I forget. Well, no, when not when was the next game. The next game was Days, and then Bird by Sleep, and then Recoded, but I don't remember when that released, though. I think it was 2012. Actually, I can check right now. because this is another secret ending, which is for Birth by Sleep. Problem is, I already played Birth by Sleep on the channel, so yeah, we don't exactly have to pay too much attention to this. But I'm gonna look up when Recoded release. Okay, so apparently it was in 2008, which comes before Days and what was it? Birth by Sleep, which is, wait, no, that's Coded. I'm stupid. When was Recoded? There we go. 2010 in Japan and then 2011 in North America. Okay, that's when Recoded was. Coded was back in 2008, which I'm pretty sure not that many people actually played, but here's the end screen, everybody. Let's read our statistics real fast, if it shows up. There we go. It's showing up really slowly, though. Game level, we already know. Critical mode, only the hardest difficulties. Gummy ship routes, 12%. Don't really care about that. Healed party members, 71 times. To be honest, I thought it would have been more than that. Saved by Mickey, twice. Use limit form the most, which I wouldn't be surprised if it was only at the end of the game. Use anti-form one time, which is very surprising. Most use summon was Chicken Little. And 76% of Jiminy's Journal. There's a lot more stuff that you can do to complete Jiminy's Journal. So, yeah. Let's end up saving the game. And everything will take place before the last Simnas boss. Just so you know. Just under 24 hours. Just barely under it. That's surprising that I managed to beat that in that amount of time. But that was it for Kingdom Hearts 2 Final Mix, and I needed to choose this new game thing so that it doesn't really just go into the opening that's in this if you wait long enough. But it's been a wild ride, but again, the Kingdom Hearts ride is not over because the next thing we have to do is watch the Recoded movie. That's going to be fun, maybe. It's going to be the same format as how the Days movie played out. I'm going to have that as three separate parts. Each of those are probably going to be an hour each. So if you guys want to view that, you can, because I'm not playing the game. I didn't play Days. I'm not going to play Recoded. So yeah, all that's next for the Kingdom Hearts series is the Recoded movie, like I just said. And then we have to do Dream Drop Distance. I don't know when I'm going to do Dream Drop Distance, though, because I do have other games planned. So it might start in December. That might be a good time, to be honest. But if it's not in December, it will be in 2018 when Dream Drop Distance starts. And then we just have Kingdom Hearts 3 after that. The wait is almost over. Kingdom Hearts 3 releases in 2018, and everything's moving very swimmingly. We don't actually have a full release window aside from 2018, but just for right now, things are getting really close. So, oh goodness. Thank you all for going throughout this entire journey throughout the past months. Like I said before, this is one of my favorite games of all time. So for you guys to be alongside me throughout this entire journey, I thank you. I thank you all. And we are almost at 300 subscribers. For all I know, this could just suddenly jump and we could get some 300 subs from that. But just thank you all. Regardless of whether I got 300 subscribers or not at this point, just thank you all. But until next playthrough, until next whatever you see of me, take care.